Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to The Tonight Show. You're here. You made it. Thank you for watching. Guys, today is February 1st. That's right. That's right. February, the special time we all forget how to spell February. Yep, it's officially February, and this year is a leap year. That's great. I think I speak for everyone when I say we could all use one more day of winter during an election year. Right? February, sponsored by Zoloft. Yes. It is the first day of February, which means tomorrow is Groundhog Day. I don't know how you guys do it, but we celebrate with my wife's family tonight and my family tomorrow. So. Meanwhile, there's now a conspiracy that Punxsutawney Phil is a government operative who's going to endorse President Biden. So I will see what happens. Speaking of President Biden, according to a new poll, he has a strong lead over former President Trump thanks to female voters. And to boost his numbers even higher with women, Biden just got Travis Kelce's haircut. Meanwhile, Trump can't understand why he's losing the female vote. He was like, no one has paid off more women than me. So I don't understand. Some more political news. Yesterday, Biden hosted Chris Evans at the White House, and he even gave him a pair of his trademark aviators. Can we see the photo? Yeah. Just to be clear, Biden's on the left. Meanwhile, this morning, Biden attended the National Prayer Breakfast. Biden actually made history as the first president to attend the National Prayer Breakfast and the Last Supper. And then at one point, people thought Biden was in deep in prayer, but he just nodded off. Well, get this. I saw that Trump finally addressed this photo from earlier this month that showed red marks on his hand. You remember that? Yeah, well, here's the photo here. Well, now he's trying to say that, explain it, said it's maybe it's AI. Yeah. He's just a troublemaker. Yeah, yeah. Well, it turns out Trump has a lot of excuses for a lot of his viral photos. For instance, for this photo, Trump said, maybe it's my new VP. Check out this one. Trump said, maybe it's Maybelline. A little here. Here's another. Trump said, maybe I'm about to go through airport security. Okay. Maybe Taylor Swift controls the wind with CIA superpowers. Maybe it's my audition for Zoolander 3. Maybe it's the edibles kicking in. And finally, here's the last one. Maybe it's the circle of life. Speaking of Trump, he owes an incredible amount of money with all his civil lawsuits and legal fees piling up. So now here to discuss it all is senior Trump campaign official Jack Snyder. Welcome to the show, Mr. Snyder. Thanks for being here, Jimmy. Now, between all the civil lawsuits and the legal fees, how much does Trump actually owe?
I'd say anywhere between 100 million and a kajillion. I mean, at a certain point, the zeros just kind of extend into space where no one can hear me scream.
There must be some way to calculate the exact amount.
Yeah, I mean, we tried. We handed Trump a calculator, but he just turned it upside down and showed us how he'd spelled out boobs.
I see. Well, when all this is said and done, will Trump still be a billionaire?
Billionaire, millionaire, thousandaire, negative billionaire. Look, these are just labels, Jimmy. But I'll put it this way. Trump could probably still afford an Applebee's Dollarita. If he drank, which he doesn't. But he probably will soon.
Is Trump looking for other ways to make money to pay for these lawsuits?
Well, Trump does have a few side hustles. He works a couple shifts at Dillard's. He sells crocheted MAGA hats on Etsy. And this is big, Jimmy. For this year's Super Bowl, he'll be the Kansas City Chiefs mascot.
Whoa, wow.
There he is. Looking good, Mr. President. Very nice.
I see. So now, how's Trump handling all this mentally?
Well, as we all know, Trump's very mentally fit. For instance, last night on his placemat, he used his crayon to solve the maze. He found hat in the word search. Look, 90% of toddlers out there can't do that.
Now, does he have anyone around him to help him deal with all this, like emotionally?
Oh, yeah, yeah. In fact, a huge celebrity just reached out to Trump to check on him and see how he was doing. You may have heard of Elmo.
Okay, okay, thank you very much. I think we heard enough. Jack Snyder, everybody. Thank you, Jack. I appreciate you being here. Did you guys see this? During a recent House committee hearing, Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene had a little trouble with the word indictable. Check this out.
This historical evidence is overwhelming that the founding fathers intended impeachment to be used to deal with the commission of indictable crimes and the abuse of power.
It's not her fault. When she reads, people always tell her to sound it out. She was like, there was a silent letter. How would I know that? Switching gears, Travis Kelce said that he won't be at the Grammys this weekend with Taylor Swift because he needs to focus on the Super Bowl. Man, you know your life is good when you can't go to the Grammys because you got to prep for the Super Bowl. You know what I'm saying? I can't go to the moon today. Taylor was like, I flew to Buffalo in January, but that's cool. You do you. Some big entertainment news. I read that Hulu just announced they're going to start cracking down on password sharing.
Oh, man, this stinks.
Sorry, Mark.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use Jimmy's Hulu anymore.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use Mark's Hulu anymore.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use Kamal's Hulu anymore.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use Higgins' Hulu anymore.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use Tariq's Hulu anymore.
Dang, I can't believe I can't use shirtless camera guy's Hulu anymore.
Dang, can't believe I can't use James's Hulu account anymore.
Wait. Jimmy, if you were using James's Hulu, who's actually paying for this account?
I don't know, but you guys can all still use my Paramount Plus.
Okay, no.
Yeah, nah. I'd rather read.
Oh, okay. Okay. Guys, listen to this. According to new research, the moon is shrinking.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's 2024. Even the moon is on Ozempic. Some business news, apparently Subway's new foot-long cookies are so popular that they're struggling to keep up with demand. Yeah, Subway's like, it's shocking. People like our cookies better than our fake tuna. Then the CEO of Subway said, ah, joke's on you, they both have salmonella. Guys, this is going viral. During a flight, an Irish folk singer pulled out a fiddle and played for fellow passengers. You know, when I'm stuck in a long flight, my first thought is, I really hope the guy next to me pulls out a fiddle. After 2 minutes, everyone's like, please, God, let the door fall off. Just, come on, I've had enough of this. Oh, my God. Finally, guys, tonight we have Sam Rockwell on the show tonight. We have Jack Whitehall on the show tonight. And then their names kind of sound similar. So it could be a little confusing. So we put together a little video to help clear things up. Take a look.
Sam Rockwell. Jack Whitehall. Sam Rockwell. Jack Whitehall. This Ken doll. Sam Rockwell. Jack Whitehall. Bond Skyfall. Sam, Jack, Rockwell, Snackwell, Samuel L. Jackson, Hot Dog, Hallwell, Jack Black, Jack White, Hall Pass, Sam Tight, Ed Rock, Jacklin, Samwise, Catwing, Jetpack, Flapjack, White House, Brat Pack, Rockwall, Ice-T, Wally, Sajak, Mark Ruffalo.
There you go, we have a great show!